Hi, I'm David Spaulding, and this is the Google Nexus 7 tablet. In this tutorial, I'm going to be talking a little bit about creating shortcuts on the home screen for your Google Drive account and for your Dropbox account if you're using Dropbox. Let's start with Drive. Drive is built into Google. It used to be called Docs, but they've expanded it to include files and collaborative documents as well. So if I want to create a shortcut for Drive, go into my apps drawer. Click Widgets, and find the Drive shortcut. Tap and hold on that, and drag that to my home screen. Now, in my case, it's going to ask me which account, because I have two different Google accounts. One of them is hosted accounts on my domain. So once I've selected that, I select a folder, and then without tapping anything else, I click Select, and it's created a folder icon on the home screen. It's not very clear, it's just a gray outline, but it works for my purposes. I can do that with a file too. Same thing, I find the Drive shortcut widget in the widget drawer, tap and hold, drag it to the home screen, go into the folder, but in this case, I select a file. It's now highlighted the file in the dialog box. I click Select, and it's created a shortcut for the document there on my home screen. I can do the same with Dropbox. Well, almost. The widget here is called a Dropbox folder. We tap and hold that, and we drag it to the home screen, select a folder on my Dropbox account that I want to use. And unfortunately, you can't select a file. All you can do is create a shortcut for a folder on the home screen. But it's a very nice looking shortcut. It's a little bit more graphically appealing than the Drive one. But when you click either of these folders, it'll take you right to that folder in that account, whether it's Dropbox or Drive. And the appeal with Drive is that we can click the shortcut for the document, and it'll take us right to the document. An appeal of this, as long as you're connected to the network, any device that you have these accounts on, you can get to the same documents. I've created the same shortcuts on my Android phone's home screen. So clicking the particular document that I loaded on my tablet, it's going to take a little longer to load it. There it is on the phone. Another appeal is that you can mark files for offline availability. Let's see if I can do that here. If I go back to here in my Drive account, click the details, shows me some details about it. There's a checkbox here for offline. A little thumbtack appears, and now it's available offline. I probably didn't do that on my phone earlier. Now, if you use two-step authentication in Google using the Google Authenticator application, there it is there, that limits access to your account to just the devices you authenticate with that six-digit code. Dropbox also offers two-step authentication, and it does it with the Google Authenticator application. So which is better? I'm really not sure. I use Dropbox a lot for sharing with others, so I have a little bit lower security on there, although I do have two-step authentication. But because I have two-step authentication on all of my Google applications, Gmail, Calendar, Drive, Google+, everything, I tend to keep my private documents on my Drive account. And I also like the fact that I can leave a shortcut on the home screen right to a particular document if I need that.